The London Tube map currently shows 16 modes of transport if you include the Overground, DLR, Trams, Tfl Rail and Thameslink. But originally it was just pure tube, and today there are 11 tube lines on the map, all with names. But how did they get those names? We'll cover them in the order that they were built, and that means starting with the Metropolitan. Constructed in 1863, it was done so by the Metropolitan Railway Company, who built many of the subsurface lines that we still use now, and it soon became common for people just to refer to it as the Metropolitan. The District Line came next, and rather cheekily, they called themselves the Metropolitan District Railway Company, which meant a rivalry between themselves and the original Metropolitan Line, which went on for many years. Eventually, though, this got abbreviated down to just the District Railway, and hence the District Line. In 1890, the first deep-level underground railways were built. What would become the Northern Line was created as the City and South London Railway. The western side was originally built as the Charing Cross, Euston and Hampstead Railway, later abbreviated to the Hampstead Tube. But as these two met at Kennington and Euston, they later merged together, and when plans came together to extend it much further north, it became known as the Northern Heights Plan. The Second World War intervened though, and the expansion never happened, but with the formation of the London Transport Passenger Board in 1933, they took the name from the Northern Heights and abbreviated the line just down to the Northern Line. In 1900, the Central Line started life as the Central London Railway, running between just Shepherd's Bush and Bank, but soon extended outside of Central London. Epping, after all, is in Essex, and thus the London part soon got dropped as it now went outside of the capital, and the word Central simply stuck. In 1906, the Bakerloo Line was built, originally called the Baker Street and Waterloo Railway, after the two stops at Rambertwain. Baker Street was actually named after William Baker, an 18th century builder, and Waterloo, of course, being named after the famous battle. But the lengthy name soon got abbreviated down, especially in the London press, where newspapers started to use the word Bakerloo instead, and that name fell into common use. In the same year, in 1906, the Piccadilly Line was originally called the Great Northern, Piccadilly and Brompton Railway, running between Finsbury Park and Hammersmith. The word Piccadilly itself comes from the word picadille, which was a large lace collar fashionable in the 16th century. People referred to the line as the Piccadilly Railway from the start, and thus later became the Piccadilly Line. So the Circle Line didn't appear on the official tube map until 1948, and became so because of the circular services that the Metropolitan and District Line shared. London Transport gave it its own official colour and name in this year, except that now, well, in 2009, the extension down to Hammersmith means that the Circle Line is no longer a circle. The Victoria Line is next, opening in 1968, and is simply named, as you might think, after Victoria Station, which in turn was simply named after Queen Victoria. Talking of royal names, the Jubilee Line was scheduled to open in 1977, and was originally going to be the Fleet Line, as the eastern part was due to run north of the Thames and along under Fleet Street. But politicians argued to have it renamed to coincide with the Queen's Jubilee in 1977, the year the line was due to open, which they successfully managed to do, but then the opening was delayed and didn't happen until 1979, 2 years after the Queen's Silver Jubilee. Next up is the Hammersmith and City Line, which first appeared on the tube map in 1990. Now, it had always been part of the Metropolitan Line, but London Transport gave it its own identity with a name and colour in this year, and is so called simply because it runs between Hammersmith through to the City of London. Although, amusingly, only three of the Hammersmith and City Line stations fall within the City of London. The Circle, District and Metropolitan Line all have more. And then that just leaves us with the Waterloo and City Line, which had been built back in 1898 and was operated for many years as a non-tube line, mostly by British Rail, up until 1994, that is, which is when it was transferred over to the London Overground and became part of the tube and the tube map. And they simply named it between the two places that it runs between, Waterloo Station and Bank, located in the City of London. And that is how all 11 tube lines got their name.